Hello everyone, I am Professor A.P. Mani from Terna Public Chartered Computers College of Engineering, Osmanabad, presenting a basic microwave communication system. As already we know, the communication system which is used to exchange information from one point to another by using different frequency signals from electromagnetic spectrum. Microwave communication system is also a type of communication system which uses microwaves or exchange of information. That information can be a text, speech, image, video, etc. Now, very firstly, we will see what is microwaves. Microwave is a signal having frequency ranges from 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz, or wavelength ranges from 1 meter to 1 millimeter in the electromagnetic spectrum. The band of frequencies, that is 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz, is called as microwave frequency band, which is further divided into three subbands, such as ultra high frequency band, super high frequency band, and extra high frequency band. Now we will see the position or location of microwave signal in electromagnetic spectrum. Now, here the electromagnetic spectrum starts from 0 hertz and it extends to infinity. So, this table shows the frequency band, corresponding wavelength bands, and the designation given to the different frequency bands. Now, as far as the microwave frequency band is concerned, which ranges from 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz, which constitutes the three bands UHF, SHF, and EHF. That means it is located or it is positioned below the very high frequency band and above the optical frequency band, from that the IR band, visible and ultraviolet band. Now, very importantly, why the microwave is very much important, for that we will see the different characteristic features of microwaves. The very first feature is its size of small size of wavelength compared to the size of components used. Secondly, it possesses a very large bandwidth compared to the other signals. Next one, it propagates along the line of sight. Again, well-known characteristic of micro signal is that the transmission of micro signal through ionosphere is possible with negligible absorption and reflection. So these microwaves requires a small antenna size, or micro communication system requires a small antenna size with excellent directivity, and the more power gain can be obtained or more power radiated from this antenna system. Again, the very well known characteristic of microwave signal is that microwave signals are well reflected from the metallic surfaces. Then another important characteristic feature is that the microwave resonance can occur in molecular, atomic, and nuclear system. That's why the microwaves are very much important in such cases or in such systems, that is a molecular system, atomic system, and a nuclear system. Now we'll see the basic microwave communication system. Basically, the basic microwave communication system consists of three main sections: the transmitter subsystem, the receiver subsystem, and a transmission media. As far as the transmitter subsystem is concerned, it consisting the different processing elements. That means it requires the generation of the generators which are used to generate the microwave signals. Again, the different processing elements or devices required as per our requirements, and finally the signal is applied to the transmitting antenna, which will radiate the signal into a free space, that is the transmission media. Like that, the receiver system consisting the receiving antenna and the required essential devices or components at the detector stage or at the receiver stage in the receiver subsystem. Now, these two figures shows in detail the transmitter system, the different devices consisting, and the receiver subsystem, again, which consists in the number of required elements. Now, as far as the transmitter system is concerned, it consisting at its very first stage, the microwave source. Here, at the very first stage, the microwave signal is generated, and by using this microwave signal, the information signal is carried over the microwave communication link. Right? So, at very first stage, the microwave source, this microwave source can be mounted on the microwave source mount, or it can be mounted inside the mount. Now, at its second stage, we require the different measuring equipments. As an example, here the frequency meter is shown. Here the frequency meter which is used to measure the frequency. Like this, for other measurements, the different meters or measuring instruments can be used at the next stage. Now, the pre and post stages of this measuring device consisting the different microwave passive devices, such as an example, the microwave isolator. This is used to isolate the important and costly source from the load side. Whereas another device which is used is a microwave attenuator. Then next one is the microwave guide. So all these are the microwave passive devices. And one more thing, or one more important thing, is that all these devices are constructed using the metal. So, because the important characteristic of microwave signal is that the microwave signals are well reflected from the metallic surfaces. Now, the next element in the transmitter subsystem is the waveguide. The basic purpose of this microwave guide is to launch the signal from the different processing stages towards the microwave antenna system. Whereas this microwave antenna, which radiates the signal into free space, that can be transmitted towards the receiver subsystem. So the receiver subsystem at its very first stage, it consisting the receiver antenna to receive the microwave signals. Whereas to launch the signal in the further circuitry from antenna, again the microwave guide is also required at the receiver subsystem stage. Now, after that, the element or device required as per our requirements are the different microwave passive devices. Here also, as like transmitter subsystems, we can use the different microwave passive devices. After that, the receiver subsystem consisting a detector stage. Here, this is a detector mount. In this detector mount, the solid state devices are mounted inside this, and these are used to detect the micro signal coming from the transmitter stage. Finally, the detected output is connected to the indicating instruments or measuring instruments such as CRO or standing wave ratio meter. Finally, the system is terminated by using the micro termination in its characteristic impedance Z0. Now, we will see all these elements which are used in the transmitter system as well as the receiver subsystem in detail. Now, its very first stage, in transmitter subsystem, the microwave source or microwave generator. So basically, the two types of microwave sources used in microwave communication system, that are the microwave tubes and microwave solid state devices. Now, first we will go for the microwave tubes. The microwave tubes are used to generate and amplify the microwave power more cheaply than solid state devices. Now, these microwave tubes uses the principle of interaction of electron beam and microwave signal in resonant cavity or slow wave structure to transfer energy or to give amplification. Now, the different types of microwave tubes used at microwaves are the klystron tube, again having the two different types, reflex klystron. This tube is used as an oscillator, whereas the another type is the two cavity klystron or multi cavity klystron tube, which is used as an amplifier. Now, the second type of microtube used is a magnetron tube, and generally this tube is used as an oscillator or to generate the microwave signal. Now, the third type of tube used is a traveling wave tube. And in at a microwave, generally this tube is used as an amplifier. Now, these are the some of the microwave solid state devices which are used for the different applications or different processing. At the very first stage, at the transmitter subsystem, microwave source stage, the different source, solid state devices or solid state sources used are the tunnel diode. These are used for the generation of microwave signal. Then that can be used for amplification of that signal. Like that, the GaN diode, it is also used to generate the microwave signal or to amplify the microwave signal. Like that, another devices such as red diodes, in that impaired diode, trapped diode, and buried diodes. These three types of red diodes are used to generate microwave signal or to amplify the microwave signal. Like that, the microwave transistors, BJTs, and FETs are also used to generate microwave signal or to amplify the microwave signal. So these are the some of the microwave solid state devices which are used at different stages. Like this, another micro solid state devices which are used are the crystal diodes. These are used at the detector stage, and that means in the very last stage, or that this can be used as a mixer. Same way, the Schottky diode, this is also used as a detector or a mixer. Then the pin diode, this solid state device is used as a modulator, as an attenuator, or as a switch. Like this, the one more important diode, which is a reactor diode. This is used in microwaves for frequency multiplication and for tuning also. Now, we'll switch over to the microwave passive devices. So these are the microwave passive devices. These are the very important devices which are used in the microwave communication link or system at different stages. Now, what these basically passive devices are, microwave passive devices, are designed using the sections of waveguide, coaxial cable, strip lines, and microstrip lines. Now, some of the important microwave passive devices are the multiple junctions, generally called as microwave T's, in that the E-plane T, H-plane T, and EH-plane T. The another components are the auxiliary components, such as directional coupler, isolator, gyrator, circulator, etc. Then the another components used, microwave passive components used, are the cavity resonators, are also called as the microwave resonators. Then microwave attenuators, in that the fixed attenuator and variable attenuators. Then the different microwave bends, such as E-plane bends and H-plane bends. Like that, the different passive devices are the microwave twist, microwave power dividers, combiners, etc. So these are the few or major microwave passive devices. Now, out of these, we will see some of the important microwave passive devices which are used in microwaves. So these are the microwave T's. These T's are constructed by using the sections of waveguides. This is the main waveguide section, which is cut on the broad wall, and another section is attached, which forms a English letter T. That's why such type of junctions or such type of connections are called as the T's, or in this case, these are the microwave T's. So basically, it is the E-plane T, because the section which is attached to the main waveguide is in the plane parallel to the electric field. That's why it is a E-plane T. Like this, another type of microwave T is the H-plane T. In this case, this section, this is attached section to the main waveguide. This is the main waveguide section, and this is the attached section, which is parallel to the H field or magnetic field. That's why it is called as a H-plane T. So one more type of this microwave T is the EH-plane T. As its name indicates, it is a combination of E-plane T and H-plane T. Here, the E-plane T, whereas this is the H-plane T. So combinedly, it is called as a EH-plane T, or it is also known as hybrid T. Many times, it is called as a magic T. Now, these are the two important micro passive devices called as a directional coupler and microcirculator. So this is a directional coupler. As its name indicates, this will couple the microwave power in a forward direction, as it is a port number 1, 2, 3, and 4. So these are the two ports which are in a forward direction. The power is propagating from this side. So it will couple the maximum amount of power at the port number 2. It will couple a fraction of power at the port number 4. And it will couple zero power at the port number 3 if the power is fed from port number 1. So that's why it is called as a directional coupler. Now the second device is the microwave circulator. As its name indicates, this will circulate the microwave power into a next immediate ports. That means, suppose if the power is launched in from this port, then this power will not go into this port. So it will circulate into the next immediate port. If the power is launched from this port, then this power will be circulated or come out from this port, not from this port. Like this, if the power is launched from this port, then this power is circulated into the next immediate ports. That's why it is called as the microwave circulator. So this is one of the important micropassive device called as the microwave isolator. Now, as far as the function of this microwave isolator is concerned, if the power is fed from this port, that is, let it is port number 1, then as it is, the power is appeared at this another port. Okay, now because of the use of this 45 degree microwave twist and the ferromagnetic material or ferrohydroid inside this waveguide section, this power propagating from this port number 1, as it is appeared at the port number 2. But in second case, if the power is launched from this port, then no power will appear at this port. So generally, such type of microwave oscillators or these devices are used after the source stage, not to get a damage of any sort of microwave sources from the overloading effects. So next device is the cavity resonators, or also called as a microwave resonators. Basically, these are of two types: rectangular cavity resonators and circular cavity resonator. These are designed from the rectangular waveguide sections, and this is designed from the circular waveguide section, right? These are the microwave bends. These are, as its name indicates, these are used to bend the microwave power into the direction of E field and H field. So this is the E plane bend. That means this is used to bend the microwave power into the plane parallel to the electric field, whereas H-plane bend, which is used to bend the microwave signal in a direction parallel to the H-field or magnetic field. Now, the very important element in the microwave communication is waveguide, or many times it is called as microwave guides. Microwave guides. So, what actually it is a structure used for transmission of microwave signal. Different waveguides used at microwave frequencies are a single conductor line. In that, the rectangular waveguide, circular waveguide, and tapered waveguide. So all these show the single conductor lines. So this is very first. It is a rectangular waveguide. This is as its name indicates, its geometry is the rectangular. That's why it is called as a rectangular. This is again made from the metal, that is the aluminium, brass, bronze, etc. Like this, another type of waveguide is a circular waveguide. This is also a circular waveguide section or circular waveguide, because its geometry is circular. That's why it is called as circular waveguide. Now, the third type of waveguide in single conductor line is a tapered waveguide. This tapered waveguide can be constructed by using the three different sections of rectangular waveguide or circular waveguide. Here, the two waveguide sections of different dimensions are connected by means of a tapered waveguide section. So it becomes a tapered rectangular waveguide. Or the circular tapered waveguide can be constructed by using the, again, the three different waveguide sections of different dimensions. Okay. Now, another type of waveguide which is used in the microcommunication system is multi-conductor line. There are coaxial cable or coaxial line, strip line, microstrip line, slot line, and coplanar line. So, as already we know, the coaxial cable, which is a two-conductor line, inner conductor and the outer conductor. So, this is also used in microcommunication for rare applications. Now, the another type is the strip line. So, this is the strip line, which consisting the multi, this is also a multi-conductor line, like that, the microstrip line, then the slot line, and a clue and a coplanar line. So these are the different types of multi-conductor lines used in microwave communication system. Now, the very last element at the transmitter subsystem and very first element in the receiver subsystem is the microwave antenna. Basically, in microwave communication system, the two types of antennas are used are horn antenna and slot antenna. So these are the some of the structures of horn antennas. So what basically horn antenna is, this antenna is not practicable, not practical at low frequencies because of the size. This can be E-plane, H-plane, pyramidal or conical type. This provides a moderate gain, and this is commonly used as a feed antennas for dish antennas or dishes. So these are the four structures or four types of horn antenna given. This is an E-plane horn antenna. This is an H-plane horn antenna. This is a pyramidal horn antenna. And this is a conical horn antenna. Now another type of antenna used at microwaves is a slot antenna. So as its name indicates, slot in the wall of waveguide act as an antenna. This slot should have a length of lambda g by 2. Slots and other basic antennas can be combined into phased arrays with many elements that can be electrically steered. Now, with this little bit explanation of microwave communication system, we will switch over to the different applications of microwaves. So there are a wide range of applications in modern technology. Out of that, some major applications are listed. Number one, very importantly, is the telecommunication application. So microwaves are mainly used for the international telephony, television, space communication, telemetry communication, etc. Though one of the great application of microwave signal is radar, radio detection and ranging. Again, radar is having the number of applications as far as military is concerned, or there are number of civilian applications such as the detection of aircrafts, tracking and guidance of supersonic missiles, observation and tracking of weather patterns, then air traffic controls, then garage door openers, police speed detectors, etc., etc. One of the important application field is a commercial and industrial application, which the microwave oven. So basically this application is coming in household application. So microwave oven in which the microwaves are used for fast food cooking. Next one, the microwaves are also used in drying machines. That means in the textile industries, food industry, paper industry, for drying the different elements in that, for drying the clothes, potato chips, printed matters, etc., etc. As far as the food industry is concerned, it is microwaves are used for pre-cooling or cooking, and for the roasting of food grains or beans. Like that, in rubber industry, in plastic industry, or in chemical industries, also the microwaves are used. Now, as far as the civil applications are concerned, the microwaves are used in mining or in public works for breaking the rocks, then tunnel boring, drying or breaking up the concretes, breaking up coal steams, curing of cement, etc. Then mainly it is used for the drying inks, drying textiles or drying grains, drying sanitizers, leathers, etc. And finally, for microwaves are also used for household appliances control. Now, not only in the military and civilian application, the microwaves are also used in biomedical field. That means for diagnostic or therapeutic process, that is diathermy for localized superficial heating, then the deep electromagnetic heating for treatment of cancer, hyperthermia, that is for local, regional or whole body for cancer therapy. Again, it is used for identifying the objects or persons by non-contact method. So these are the major applications of microwaves. So in the next session, we will see the detailed explanation of all these elements used and the different applications of microwaves. Thank you and see you again.